My hope today is to kind of level set as we get started here today in our time together. A huge passion of mine is customer experience. My personal philosophy when it comes to that is really that every touch point with a customer is marketing. And I'll talk about that as we kind of go through our time together. As Sinan said, I serve on the board. I work at Microsoft. I have probably one of the most fun jobs at Microsoft. I get to look across all of our suite of technologies and figure out what we can do to help marketers. So everything from our advertising division to things like predictive and machine learning to cloud technology and looking across everything. So it's a really fun role that I have there. I also teach marketing for UC Irvine. So it's just a lot of fun getting to help and work with people. I wanted to take a quick poll in the room here. Not how many have watched Lord of the Rings. Hopefully every hand would go up. How many of you have gone through your end-to-end customer journey? Be it in B2C, B2B, how many of you have done that? I got three hands. Okay, have you done it in the last quarter? All right, still a couple hands, but majority are down. Keep that in mind as we go through this here. This is designed to be a little bit of a marketing intervention, kind of to kick us off, to get us level set, right? How many of you think customer experience is important? I hope I see every hand because it's a huge passion of mine. The interesting thing is as we take a look at it and as we look at ourselves and we look around this room, we still kind of suck at customer experience and actually going through and sitting in the shoes of our customers, right? But how can it be that way if we have so much data at our fingertips, right? As we look at this, you've got CRM data, you have email data, you have social data, you have in-mail, you have SEM, SEO, right? All these data sources that you have. We have so much data today, more than we've ever had in our lifetime. But we still are terrible at customer experience, right? How can we have all of this data and still struggle with this, right? There's over 2,000 companies in the marketing technology space. You're gonna get to hear from some amazing ones throughout this conference, as well as if you come to Impact in Vegas. And many of these are friends of mine. Most of these companies I work with regularly. And it's really interesting we look at that because as we continue to add more applications, we continue to get more data. And data leads to dashboards. How many of you guys have dashboards? How many of you like your dashboards? All right, and what we've learned is, right, dashboards lead to analysts, right? And analysts just lead to more costs, and we've done this, we've tried this, we've continued down this road, and we're still sucking at customer experience. So now is kind of this time, this concept of transformation, and the key thing I want to land here is that transformation is not just technology. You can't just throw technology at something and expect your business to change overnight. Tech transformation involves three core things as we go through it. It is part technology, but it's also part process, and it's very much so part culture. This is something Microsoft is going through right now as we shift from an engineering-led company trying to make that shift over to becoming a people-centric company. It is very interesting seeing the culture shift that is trying to go on there and the dynamics that are changing there. So transformation is this three-part process. And I'd love to share a story about an organization real quick that has gone through this and that we're doing some really interesting things down this road. I'm gonna point that. There we go.
We live in a world of mobile technology. But it is not the device that is mobile. It is you.
When there is a game, when there is a training, when there is a goal, our duty is to bring that information as fast as possible to the people. Real Madrid have about 450 million fans. We're trying to give them all the feeling of being at the stadium. The Microsoft Cloud gives us the scalability to communicate exactly the content that people want to see. Microsoft Cloud allows us to establish a relationship that is more personal, is more direct with the fans. It will help people connect to their passion of living Real Madrid.
So it's my job is rough, right? I have to work with organizations like that. Any Real fans in the room? All right, a couple. All right, good. Real came to us with a really interesting question, the way I like to think about this is, right, we've got a lot of data, and the thing, if you try to just comb through your data and look for meaning, it's kind of like looking for a needle in a haystack, My way that I love to approach when you're looking at data and problems as an organization is to start with a question. And that's exactly what we did with Real. And we said, how do I better engage my fans around the globe? They have over 500 million fans in their database, as you take a look at that. And they say, how do I engage those people, right? And so we looked at this and said, okay, well, what do people have? Okay, look in your pocket. All of you probably have your cell phone within reaching distance of you right now. I said, all right, mobile is the obvious choice from this. I said, okay, what are the most important things to the fans? So we started to go through these different processes and doing some research. And the answers seem obvious, but we wanted to make sure that they were backed by data. And so we came through and said, all right, so they really would like to watch the games. No duh. So we continued down that road and said, well, how do we make that more personal? And so we actually worked with the team to create this experience where through mobile, you could pick which view you wanted from the field, the pitch, right? So now you can follow your favorite player, these sorts of things. Now we're sucking in that kind of data, and now we're starting to get into this e-commerce phase with them as we take a look at that, where I can now predict who is your favorite player, and then we can service up things like jerseys and stuff like that in context of it. Now we're looking to take this to the next step with them as we continue this partnership, looking at simple things like, who likes watching sports alone? Anybody? All right. So how do we connect you with other Real fans, right? Where's the local Real bar? Because there's so many around the globe. So now, again, mobile being kind of that core piece there. And so I use them as an example of a company that really has started becoming customer-centric, fan-centric in this instance. And they're looking at how do we activate our fan base and then start to monetize it by delivering value, not just delivering annoying marketing, right, and annoying offers to them. And so it's really, really fun as we start to look at these different pieces here as we go through it. So this kind of brings up an interesting topic that Sinan touched on, right? As we start to look at this future, like data and predictive as we start to head down this road is really interesting. And I do believe it is the future of marketing in a huge way. But how many of you are familiar with Tay? All right, so if you're not familiar with Tay, Tay is a wonderful, sweet, teenage AI bot that Microsoft released to the world a couple weeks ago on Twitter. Tay very quickly is this isolated AI that has never seen the world before and encountered Twitter, started to learn from Twitter. Tay was sweet. Hi, world. Tay very quickly, and this is the cleanest one I could find, right? You are dumb too, right? Tay is now insulting people on the internet. Tay, by the end, was spouting off racial slurs and all kinds of crazy stuff. Thought Hitler was cool. Like, Tay was broken, and that's what happened to Tay. Tay is offline right now. So we're working on that. But just this last week at Microsoft's developer conference called Build, this idea of a bot is starting to come out. This is kind of one of the futures that we take a look at here in the space of, we call these bots. And these bots, as we're starting to design them, are pulling in, it's this idea that you and I are having a conversation on Skype, on whatever technology that we're having as friends. Maybe we're talking about coming to the Caymans. Well, we're partnering with the Westin in this instance and looking at it and saying, oh, hey, I'm going to come to the Caymans. Well, the Westin bot could pop in and be like, hey, we're running a great sale right now at the time frame that you're here. And then we're like, yeah, what should we do? What activities? What's most popular? Have you thought about the snorkeling? And then the bot could come in and start adding in more information, right? Enriching our conversation. So part of the direction as we start to look at this is what's the future of AI and brands and how do you change the conversation? Because one of the favorite quotes that we did or that I got out of a study that we were doing on the way customers make their decisions was that advertising that I don't like is spam, right? But advertising in context in when I need it is actually a service. Right, so how do you take that language and that barrier that we have and then interpret that data and service up something that is genuinely wanted and genuinely a service, right? You're enriching my experience as opposed to just hitting me with a bunch of random stuff as we take a look at that. And so it's really interesting as we start to look at these, we're partnering with several companies as you look through this, but they're all routed through your personal digital assistant, right? Something you've come to trust. If you use Siri, if you use Google Now, if you use Cortana, right, these are things that we've all kind of grown to start trusting in our lives, these digital assistants. So the question is, how are brands going to start taking advantage of these digital assistants that are out there? However, all of that to say, wow, this sounds like a silver bullet to marketing, right? This auto interprets and delivers everything. Where have we heard that before? Right? We've gone on this road many, many times. The silver bullet. This is going to fix marketing and lead this change for us. Right? Pay-per-click. One of the first ones. Hugely important. Great strategy. It was an early promise in its early days. Right? Next, that moved to SEO. And SEO was the big hot thing everybody needed to do. And then email marketing was the next big thing. Then marketing automation, right? And as we continue down this road, content marketing, content is king. We have to do content marketing. And we head into account-based marketing now as a present one that you'll hear a lot about. And even getting back into predictive marketing. And as Sinan talked about, this dinner that we were at was about the future of marketing. And what I've come to realize is that most brands, we as marketers love to chase after the shiny object, right? And we may not be mature where we need to be first before we can effectively adopt those new technologies, right? Before we're ready to actually come out and adopt the next hot thing that's out there. Yes, you may jump around and move ahead as we go through those, but each one of those strategies that I just mentioned, hugely important, you have to do it, but you also need to mature in it as well over time and actually learn how to use it effectively before you just move on. And so today I'm actually really excited and I would love feedback on this. I'm in process of starting a book around a whole model designed around that exact concept. And so it's around this journey to becoming a mature marketing organization that's focused on the customer as we go through it here. And so simply put, we have two key lines that I've kind of come to adopt. And it's looking at this idea that, right, you have a vast number of companies as they come down, and as they mature, the number of technologies that they're using, they're decreasing. And on this side, the impact of your marketing maturity and the impact of that comes through. And so we start to look at things, right? We've got things like basic social, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, right? Stuff you just start to do. These are things that small businesses do. Pay-per-click, website, right? Common things that you need to have in place. Then we start to get a little bit more advanced. We start to look at things like responsive web, right? As we start to go through these. Marketing automation. Maybe you're getting into personalized versus just, hey, you have, hey, Jeff, right? That's awesome. And Greg, you'll see I stole some, or didn't steal, I was interviewed for part of this with Teradata as we get through here. But as we continue to go through, we look at content marketing, getting more advanced in our website strategies, mobile, attribution. You might be doing advanced SEO now as you take a look at this. Then you get into account-based marketing, right? Propensity modeling, individualized. Greg, I got that from your team. I was on the interview for that, and I agree with the model on that. Getting into real-time personalization, this is something that blows my mind, how few companies do this, but the technology's been out there. It's because they're not advanced. They're not mature enough with their data and their strategies to be able to adopt this technology yet. Then we get into things like predictive marketing, IoT, oh my goodness, right? You hear this, it's a buzz term. How many companies are really starting to implement this and actually leverage it? Advanced ABM, advanced mobile, DMPs, right? VR, AR, we get into prescriptive, and then AI. And I think AI is at the very tall end of this maturity model as we take a look at it. And so what we start to see here is marketing, as we go through this journey, shifts from being a cost center to being viewed as an investment. You shift from being fluffy marketing and brand and colors to actually driving impact and driving revenue. You shift from being from data and just having data to gaining knowledge to gaining insight as a core part of that as well. And so I broke this into five key areas as I'm looking at this and saying, you know, there's kind of foundation 101, the stuff you've got to do as a business. And then as you start to mature, marketing starts to become an actual function inside of your business. And then marketing is becoming very core to your strategy as we go through that. And then you'll note there's this kind of inflection point here where these two cross. And this is where I believe the shift to becoming more customer-focused starts to happen, right? You're starting to get down to the individual that you're taking a look at. And then ultimately you end up with the customer as the center of your business. And I don't mean this as just as marketing. I mean this as across engineering, from sales to customer service. The customer truly is the core part of your business. And so there is this inflection point, and I think this is where my philosophy begins to come real, is that as companies mature in their marketing technology and their approach to it, they have to put the customer at the center of this. And that's where that inflection point starts to happen. So I have two challenges for you guys today as I close my time here, and happy to talk with you guys after this as well. Number one, give yourself an honest assessment. Where are you as a business on this model? Where do you fit? Where, and as you look at it, what is that journey to move forward? And this isn't in order of operations or anything like that. It's taking a look at just different pieces of kind of what as these things fit together. And you might jump ahead. You might have some things that are way out in front versus your core strategy. But what does that journey look like as you go through it? And the second that I have for all of you is go take your customer journeys, right? Write down what was great, write down what sucked, write down where there was friction, and then take that feedback back to your team. Don't tell your teams you're doing this either, right? You don't want them to be ready for it. Try calling your customer service line. How many of you have ever done that? That's always fun, right? And looking at those different pieces, what is that holistic customer experience as you go through it there? So my two challenges for you today, number one, really kind of do that assessment of where you are with your marketing and your maturity level. And number two, take that customer journey. And I would welcome you to give me feedback. Let me know how it goes. My personal email is on there for the IMA and would love the chance to talk with you guys more about those different steps. So with that, I will hand it over to Sinan, who will introduce our next speaker. So thank you all.